Hello everyone, welcome to a brand new tutorial. I have been living in the Middle East for quite a few years now, and I just wanted to paint something celebrating the natural beauty of a desert. I hope through this painting I can showcase the dunes and the sands in its golden glory and also simplify my techniques for you. I start with a basic sketch of a hand and then start painting the sky with light grey and white and then blend it out with cadmium yellow medium. My suggestion at this stage would be to spend quite some time blending the colours on the dune and the sand, as it needs to be the perfect backdrop for the setting sun, the hand and the falling sand. I have not diluted my paint too much and have kept it pretty thick, and have used a dry blending method for a smooth transition between the colors. I have mostly used my Filbert No. 12 synthetic brush for my landscape and have used the dry blending method. Dry blending simply means we are taking very little water in our brush or no water at all and trying to blend the different colors. I personally find this method very helpful, and usually I prefer a dry old scruffy brush for this, but since I wanted to cover a larger surface, I chose the Filbert brush. Now for the details, the highlights, it was added in lemon yellow and I used a brush pen, but you could use any brush. While painting the hand, the point that you need to keep in mind is that the midsection has to be a lot lighter. For that, you can mix a little bit of white with your yellow ochre too. The starting point and the fingers were kept dark using burnt sienna and vermilion red. Thank you. While painting the sun's rays, the points that you need to keep in mind are that the rays need to be straight no matter the angle, so you need to keep a steady hand. A flat brush would help you in pulling the paint out in straight lines, and the center of the rays should be kept white and yellow towards the sides. The yellow on the sides of each ray should be blended with the hand, as it helps in creating a soft glow. Otherwise, it would just end up looking like lines and not sun's rays. A few more details on the fingers using burnt sienna. To paint the falling sand, first a base was painted using yellow ochre. I used a dry brush and just a little bit of paint to create a foggy background for the falling sand. I also used a toothbrush to spray paint for the fine dots, and I used a long hair 000 brush to paint the bigger sand grains, especially in the middle. I kept repeating the process several times till I was satisfied with my results. But again, art is subjective, and as I always say, see it, understand it, and make it your own. You'll have a lot more fun that way. While using the toothbrush for spray painting, I have made sure to cover the rest of the painting with paper, as we do not want to spray paint anywhere else. And I would strongly recommend not to skip this step. After repeating the steps several times, and when I was pretty satisfied with the way the sand was falling down, I decided to add few bright grains of sand, and for that I mixed yellow ochre and white. With that I made few dots, especially on the sides and in the middle. With this, we come to the end of this tutorial. I hope you had as much fun as I had with this. Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Thank you so much for your time. Bye.